the heart of brotherly love and Billy Paul's crib. It's Philly Sounds and Beyond, starring Billy Paul and his Mrs. Jones, Blanche Williams.
Hi, and welcome to the Philly Sounds and Beyond show, and welcome to our home. I'm Blanche Williams.
And I'm Billy Paul.
For the next hour, we're going to be playing music from some of our friends in Philly, some rare, some unreleased, and some that you'll know. And we're also going to talk about what we've been doing, and we're going to share some stories from the road. We're going to talk about what's going on with us. We're going to just have fun. This is going to be a fun show. We're going to be playing the music that we like, music that we play in our house, the songs that have meant something to us.
And on today's show, another pioneer of the Philly Sounds will be stopping by, Mr. Russell Thompkins, formerly of the Stylistics, to share his new music.
All this and more when we come back to Philly Sounds and Beyond.
Contact Billy and Blanche. Go to www.billypaul.com.
We got a thing.
Welcome back. Billy, you know, we've been together for 37 years now, which is, that's a major feat in this business, folks. And I know the people that you've loved and you that were close to you throughout your career and enduring your career. And one of those people was Marvin Gaye. And I know how devastated you were when he passed. But, you know, can we talk a little bit about you and about Marvin and what it was like being like a good friend with him and to him and for him? You guys were pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, it's like that, you know, it's no secret. We can go so far back down in the den when Marvin brought Jan and her mother by. You remember that?
Yeah, I do.
And asked her, it came to us and asked, should he marry her, you know? I mean, I took him off to the side, but to this day, you know, I never told you what we talked about, you know? But, because I gave my decision, but the mother was there too.
I know what you talked about. You told him, "Gad, she's too young."
Well, you can't keep no secrets. yeah, that's what I told him. But yeah, we didn't lose no friendship over it, you know, because he did good things and he came by and I played on the Fender Rhodes piano that I just bought and played some things that he was doing on the Hear My Dear album, you know. And I mean, the way you take care of your mom, you know. And when I talked to Russell, I talked to Russell about the moments we've had some good times, you know. Sure. When you came and looked for us, you know.
But you know, Billy, I think the thing that I remember most about Marvin was my mother came to live with us. She moved from the East Coast to the West Coast. And we had to go on our first tour, and my mother was really afraid to be in the house alone.
Yeah.
And I remember Marvin saying, "Don't worry about it. You know, I'll just go and do what you have to do, and I'll check on your mom."
Yeah.
And I remember my mother told me that, oh, so many times during that tour while we were away, he would come by there, he would check on her in person, he would call her on the phone to make sure that she was okay. And you know what, that told me a lot about who he was as a human being. He was a sweet man, and I really loved him a great deal.
But you know,
he was fine too.
Well, you come to an entertainer, you know. I think that I'm one of the few people that knew Marvin inside and out, like I knew Eddie Kendricks. Inside and out. We used to talk about our frustration. We used to talk about the music that we thought we should have done, given the song that we weren't comfortable with, you know what I mean? And so we sort of had like the same life. And the day, it's only 2 days that I can remember, the day that he died, and the day that my sister died, and the day that Frank Sinatra died, it seemed like the earth just came up from under me, you know? Because, you know, I'm much better with death, you know, yeah. You know that.
But it impacted on you to such an extent that as a part of your show, you did a tribute to Marvin Gaye.
Yeah.
You used a couple of the songs that you liked, that you felt suited your voice. You put them into a medley, and you put it in your show, and you eventually wound up recording it as a part of a live performance.
Because we've talked about what's going on, and I talked about war to God, about society, about religion, about man's inhumanity to man. And we were on the right track when it came to that. He did it his way, I did it my way.
But I remember the first few times that you did that medley, it was difficult to get through that medley. And as you continued to do it, you know, it got easier. But I remember a few times I was in tears when you were trying to get through that medley. So, Billy, why don't we play that medley? Why don't we play that, your tribute to Marvin? Why don't we play that right now?
Okay.
Right now, I like to do a song that I often think about my brother, who I spent a lot of time with, and I've been able to continue on with this music. And as many of you will know, we go back a long time. Mr. Marvin Gaye.
I've been really trying, baby, trying to hold back the tears for so long. And if you feel like I feel, mama, shamo, 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 shamo,
let's get on. Let's get on.
Understanding sugar.
Let's get on.
Sensitive people with so much to give. Understanding sugar, since you got to be, let's live. I love you. There's nothing wrong with me loving you. No, 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 no.
What's going on?
Tell me what's going on.
What's
Billy, that's such a great version. That I love that. I love the way you do that. And where was that recorded?
Well, honey, we recorded that live at the Palais de Congrès in Paris.
That's right. That's right. You know, if Marvin were here, I really believe that he would like that version. He would like what you did with his music. Stay tuned. We're going to be right back. So hang in there. When we come back, we're going to be interviewing Russell Thompkins, the voice of the Stylistics, on Philly Sounds and Beyond.
You're listening to the legendary Philly Sounds and Beyond.
You've just listened to part one of Philly Sounds and Beyond with Billy Paul and Blanche Williams. Coming up next, Billy and Blanche is visited by Russell Thompkins Jr. from the Stylistics here on Philly Sounds and Beyond.
You're listening to Philly Sounds and Beyond with Blanche Williams and Billy Paul.
Welcome back. This is our new show, our first show, and we are taping at Billy's crib. Actually, crib. Billy and Blanche's crib. Actually, Billy, Blanche, and Bijou's crib. And in case you don't know who Bijou is, hang around, you'll find out. Bijou is dog boy.
Sneaky dog.
He's Billy's dog boy. You know, these people that that don't have children, and they take the little animals and they make them little kids, well, that's who Bijou is. But at any rate, welcome back. Russell Thompkins Jr., the voice of the Stylistics, has just stopped by. Russell, welcome to Philly Sounds and Beyond.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
It's our pleasure.
And hey, Russell, you know, me and you go back so long, you know. It's so funny because this is one of my hood boys, you know. His mom and my mom is from the hood. And, you know, I just light up every time I see Russell. Because the greatest thing about the career is that one of the guys from the neighborhood, you made it to, and I mean, right around the corner, you know. And I've always loved that, you know. And every time I tell people I'm from Philly, I tell them I'm from the same neighborhood. Russell Thompson, we from the same neighborhood.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
But welcome, Russell.
Thank you very much.
Welcome to my crib.
Right on.
To the Brits.
You were the old head in the neighborhood.
Yes, he was.
You had hit records out long before we even thought about singing.
Yeah, he's a couple years old.
Yeah, I'm a senior citizen now.
Inspiration.
Yeah.
Russell, what have you been up to?
Well, after 35 years of doing the stylistic thing, I left in 2000 and I went back to school. I'm studying music now at the Settlement Music School in Philly.
Excellent. I read that in your bio. I was happy to hear that.
And that same year, I decided to do a solo recording, which was not too much different than the recording I had been doing for the last 35 years anyhow.
You've got a new album out. What's the name of it? What's the title?
The Russell Thompkins Jr. Collection, A Matter of Style. It's on the Forevermore label.
And it sounds good.
Thank you.
In fact, we're going to be playing a couple of cuts from Russell's new album today. We're going to play, two songs from that album. And we're also going to play a Stylistics song.
Well, that's me too.
Because absolutely. You know, Russell, when I think about all the multitude of hits the Stylistics had, and every time I hear a Stylistics song in my head, the only voice that I ever hear is you. So you truly are the voice of the Stylistics.
Well, that's because it was just me. And yeah. The Philly sounds, the Philly Angels, yeah. Other background singers, ooh, Kenny Gamble,
yeah.
Tommy Bell,
yeah. Bunny Sigler,
yeah,
me, I'm
Billy
the
Paul,
Blue Note, and the Blue Note stuff.
A couple other people who just yeah. stopped past, you know, yeah,
yeah,
DJs.
Yeah, yeah, just stop by the studio and you wind up singing.
End up singing.
You know the deal.
But the first three albums were really done like that, you know, with yeah. Tommy. And not to put anybody down, but yeah. the rest of the group just didn't have any part in it. Just
yeah.
on the Rock and Roll Baby album, one of the guys sang on You Make Me Feel Brand New.
But you know, Russell, when we look at it, sometimes when we stop by the studio, I would be in there or you'd be in there, and you'd be surprised who they got. And you know who sing background, because we don't tell you who, but some people play the background part, but they wasn't on the records. You know what I mean? You know, and Motown did the same thing too. And some yeah. of them.
But that distinctive voice on all the right. leads was very definitely you. I'm curious. What was it like to work in the studio with Tom Bell and Linda Creed? That duo.
Well, because it was like in the beginning of my career, it was a discovery. We had been in the studio once before when we did our first record, You're a Big Girl Now, down at Frank Virtue's studio.
Oh my goodness, yeah, Street. I remember.
Okay.
And after we did that, I got a word from the record company in New York saying to report to the building. What was the building?
309?
No, not 309 then. It was the old building across the street. Brewery building.
That was
the business building right across from 309.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I was asked to come down there and... you know, it's like a job interview. Be down there at certain 9 o'clock in the morning.
2:20.
Yeah. And report to a Tommy Bell.
Yeah, 2:20.
Uh-huh. And I went in there with Tommy Bell and sat down. He sat at the piano and he wanted to see where I was coming from.
Mm-hmm.
And I started singing. He said, whoa, wait a minute. We got to bring them notes down some. You're singing too high.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
And he put me into a nice, comfortable thing. And like I said, during that time, I was imitating a lot of other singers because I didn't have anything of my own. I like to sing Dionne Warwick songs, a lot of female songs. And he brought me down and really gave me a vocal identity.
Mm-hmm.
And that was just, you know, that's the best thing I think I really, except for the hits, mm-hmm. the best thing I got was a vocal identity from Tommy Bell.
Because when you hear Russell Thompkins, you know it's Russell Thompkins Jr. You know it's Russell Thompkins Jr.
Yeah. You know, it wasn't so funny because I got... Even when I first started singing, I was doing Nancy Wolfe and stuff, and Nina Simone stuff. And 90% of my stuff was I was doing female material.
Female, mm-hmm. yeah.
You know, because of the range of my voice. You
right.
know what I mean? So, but I mean, you've always been a master. I always said that it was only two falsettos in the world that grew me. That was you and
Eddie Kendricks.
Eddie Kendricks, my boy.
I got a chance to spend time with Eddie also, just like you said. He helped me out a lot, you know, when I first started. 35 years of being in the business, around 1969, we had just started, you know, recording. And there was a lot of problems. There's been problems in the Stylistics for a long time, and a lot of people wouldn't even know it. And at that time, I was going to leave the group.
Mm-hmm.
And Eddie Kendricks, he came to me. He said, "Do you know how many people you feed?"
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't think about it like that. He said, "You see all them people on stage with you, all them guys singing and stuff like that."
Yeah.
He said, "Their mothers, their kids, their wives." He said, "You're feeding all of them." And that's the reason why I stayed with the group as long as I did.
35 years later, do you regret it?
In some ways, yes. But for the experience, the music that I made, the traveling, people I've met.
Yes.
Hindsight is 20/20.
But Russell, you know, like we have went places, and most of my work is international, and also most of y'all work was international, and we have crossed paths in foreign countries, and you know, it's so good about that because you can always go back by yourself, because they want to hear that voice.
Yeah. I remember our paths crossed in Japan, and I think you guys have been there for a while. And for those of you that don't know, Japan is like, what, 12 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours?
13 hours.
13 hours. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So like midnight to your body is like 12 noon for them. So it took me forever to get acclimated to that climate, to the time. And it was awful. It was a nightmare for me. And we ran into you and folks.
Oh, we had a wonderful
the Stylistics
time.
Are like icons. They're icons in Japan, you know. And it was wonderful. I remember we hung out in a little Western American cafe.
The so-called American bar.
The American bar.
4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, we had a great time.
We had a good time. Yeah.
But the Stylistics were the bomb over there, boy.
The
Japanese love the Stylistics.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
And Australia do too.
Yeah, in Japan.
Yeah.
Japan and England, we had as many hits as we had in here in the U.S. Been very lucky to get an international audience. Any artist is lucky to get an international audience. Yeah. Yeah. But in today's troubling times, it's not as easy to travel around the world as we did before.
No, well, this is also true. You know, I still go, but I'm careful where I go. We can't pick and choose like we used
to
before, you know?
Russell, let me ask you something. After 35 years of being a part of the Stylistics, what's it like for you today being a solo artist?
It's almost the same because...
How so?
Being the lead vocalist, I was always standing alone. You know, I always recorded alone. Mm-hmm. When I was on stage, I always had to be out front.
Mm-hmm.
So with my new organization, it's built almost the same way, except it's more band orientated, and I'm just out front again.
Mm-hmm. So there's not really a big difference for you then, when you think of it that way.
Yeah, because really I just take the microphone and and it's me and the people.
Right. Yeah. And I want you to know, Russell, you know, I heard you singing last weekend. You haven't lost a step, not a stroke, not a beat, not a note. You haven't lost anything. Okay. In fact, now would be a good time. Let's take a listen to a song from your new album. What's the first song going to be?
The song is called Jealousy. In fact, it's a remake originally done by Dionne Warwick, recorded by Tommy Bell.
Okay, great. Let's listen to that. Sound terrific. Let's break for a commercial right now, and when we come back, we're going to hear another cut from Russell's new album, A Matter of Style.
You're listening to the legendary Philly Sounds and Beyond.
Hey, Blanche, you forgot to tell them that if you want to find out anything about us, they can go to BillyPaul.com.
Yeah, on BillyPaul.com we have a video that you can download. There's information about what's going on with us. There's photos, there's bios. There's a lot going on on our website.
You can also find out what I've been doing for the last, I ain't going to say how many years I've been in showbiz, but some years. They can find out what I've been doing through the years.
Yeah, and that's BillyPaul.com. That's real easy, right?
Yeah, very easy. How can I forget?
We'll be getting back to more of Philly Sounds and Beyond in just a moment. But, you know, this was the first show we put together with Billy and Blanche. And after we recorded this show, the following day, Billy was rushed to the hospital with a serious illness. And, of course, like an old trooper, he bounced back. As a matter of fact, I was looking on the net the other day, and I was reading some reviews on some shows he did overseas. And they were saying that he's putting on the most unbelievable shows he's ever done in years. And I think it's all contributed, of course, from good living and, you know, good loving, of course. And he stopped smoking cigarettes, both him and Blanche, a while ago. So let's get back to more of Philly Sounds and Beyond, recorded at Billy's house with Billy Paul, Blanche Williams, and Russell Thompkins Jr. from the Stylistics. You're listening to Philly Sounds and Beyond with the ever smooth Mr. Billy Paul and the beautiful Blanche Williams.
Hey, we're back. Russ, why don't you give the audience some information how they can buy your CD?
Well, the name of the CD is Russell Thompkins Jr. Collection, A Matter of Style, and it's on the Forevermore label, and it's being sold at Amazon.com and Forevermore.com.
Okay.
Okay, Russell, any parting thoughts?
I'd like to say that the other night when I was at Billy's show, that it was very pleasing. You go to a lot of shows and then you scrutinize the entertainer. You think this is right. You think this is not right. What the show did for me the other night was make me feel happy.
Yeah. Oh, great.
And it was just enjoyment. And I think the crowd felt, everybody felt the same way. It was just, you enjoyed it. It was an enjoyable show.
If I can say anything, Russell, I think the greatest thing that I received from you was seeing you have Kenny Thompson and you got an awesome band. And you know, like, I never consider myself, I know, we all here from my neighborhood. And I never call myself a singer. I call myself a musician, because you're a musician. Yeah. We've been in the business so long. But to see you with the band that was so lethal and playing behind the Stylistics, and then now they're playing for Russell Thompson, you can't do wrong, my brother.
We work so much that we don't get a chance to really go out to see people, but that night we were coming.
Yeah. It was a pleasure.
I waited for you all night too, Russell.
We crossed
each other paths and we're friends, but you'd be going one way out of the country, I'd be going another. And like to have you into my house just doing this radio show, it's such a blessing.
You know? Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
It was our pleasure.
Yeah. Hey, Russell, let me say something. I'd like to play one of your songs off the Stylistics album. Can I ask you a question? Did you ever have any favorites?
Well, my favorite is one of your favorites, because you told me this in Japan. It was Bet You By Golly Wow.
Okay.
Let's hear Bet You By Golly Wow, and we're going to play another song from Russell's new CD, A Matter of Style. Russell, what's the next song we're going to play from your new CD?
Nothing in This World.
Okay. Bet You By Golly Wow, Nothing in This World. Russell Thompkins, Jr. Okay.
Russell, I'd like to thank you. Blanche, I'd like to thank you for stopping by.
Thank you very much. Where's the chicken?
That's right, you are at Billy's crib. Thanks, Russell.
You are every part of me, and I with every beat my heart demands that you give your love to me the way no other can, and I really mean it. And when I say I love you, I know I need no other plan, so let me take you in my arms.
to the legendary Philly Sounds and Beyond.
We're back. At the top of the show, I said that we would be playing some music by friends of ours from the Philly Sound and beyond. And right now, we would like to play a song for you that we play at home, songs that we like to play, and this is going to be one of them. And Billy, you know, Nina Simone, that was one of your influences, too.
Yes, and we, you know, I met her, we had a club together.
Yeah.
Roland Brown, Buster's Club, and I met Nina in 1965, the 28th in July. And then we did the convention hall, me, her, and Nancy Wilson. And I go back with her, like, so many years, and she lived in the building at the River Loft for 22nd.
Our paths crossed quite a few 23rd times,
And Walnut.
Yeah.
And I go back with her so many years, and I was really sorry to hear about her death. She was buried, you know, she died of cancer. She was buried in France.
What song are we going to play?
We're going to play the song that we played in our apartment when we first met, I Love You, Porgy.
Oh, okay.
Nina Simone.
Good choice.
If you can keep me. I wanna stay here with you forever. I've got my.
Before we close, I want to thank Russell Thompkins for coming by my crib, you know, me and your crib, Billy and Blanche's crib, on Philly Sounds and Beyond. And Russell, I really want to thank you a lot, you know.
All right, man,
I
thank you.
Thank you for coming by, because you're a hell of an artist, you know, and you're still great. The old, you can mellow with age.
Thank you.
I want to thank you, Russell, and Blanche, till the next time we have Philly Sounds and Beyond. They want to hear from us.
Oh, Billy, before we leave, I'd like our audience to know that on July 11th, you will be receiving the United States Congressional Lifetime Achievement Award in San Francisco at the Plush Club. And I know how excited you are about receiving that award.
Yeah, I'm excited receiving something from Congress.
Yes.
At least I know they kept tabs on me knew right there.
Well, we're both excited. Hey. So long for now.
People make the world go round.
You're listening to the legendary Philly Sounds and Beyond.
Well, I hope you enjoyed our first show. What a great show, too. I mean, Billy and Blanche are...